was with you. Amen. Was precious to heal that.
Okay.
You know, don't tell her today. Don't tell her. 1 Thessalonians 3. Okay, 1 Thessalonians 3, 13, 11. No, this is 12. And the Lord make you to increase and abound in love one toward another, toward all men, even as we do toward you. See, when you fail to strengthen the hand of the needy and poor, when you fail to, amen, to sow into the lives of those hanging out of church, amen. Some of those that I called last night, I prayed, boy, I just, amen, one of them is here today. I ain't going to tell you who it is, and you don't even know. There's no way you will know. Amen. She's smiling and looking happy. Woo! Now, you know, that makes me happy too. That makes me want to what? Go on with the Lord. Go on. Amen. And that overshadows, things like that will overshadow tons of negative things that's happening in the church that you can't deal with naturally. You can't normally deal with. Sometimes things make you sick at the stomach. But how do you get beyond that by getting involved? Don't be overcome with evil. All right. Overcome evil with what? With good. All right, see here? Abounding in love, one toward another, toward all men, even as we do toward you. To the end, he may establish your hearts unblameable in holiness before God.
Amen.
That's how you can begin to live a perfect life. See, that's the reason why there's so much emphasis on works, 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 works. Whosoever looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continue therein, being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work,
yes,
that man shall be blessed in all of his deeds.
Amen.
The key, Brother Holman, you've already figured this out. The key is in what? The works.
Right.
Loving folk.
Mm-hmm.
Abounding in love. Taking time.
Yes.
Amen. Last night I said, man, I got 2 hours here, man. I could be studying my message. But if I had studied my message rather than called in, it might not have been the message. It might have turned from a message to a mess. Amen. But I got something that I couldn't get no other way. Amen. When I began to pray for those people.
Amen.
And I think that this is something that all of us ought to really understand how vital this is in terms of building ourselves up. We can't build ourselves up unless we want help to build what? Somebody else up. All right. Ooh, give me Glory. Okay, turn over to Ezekiel. Amen. Praise God. Ezekiel. Now, there are three classes of people. Three classes of people that we just got to do something about. If we don't, woe to us. There are three classes of people that's around us that we got to do something about. If you want to be established in holiness, if you don't want to get sidetracked and distracted, if you want to really begin to work works that will cause, amen, the Lord to say, well done, thou faithful, good and faithful servant. If you really want an abundant interest into the kingdom, an abundant interest, you know, some people will just get in by the skin of the teeth. And all they will, God can't entrust them with any type of responsibility. They made it by the what? Skin of the teeth. And those are the people that we used to sing about, walk around in heaven all day. They're going to be the walkers. So I'm saying, well, if I can just walk down the pearly streets of gold, I'll just be as happy as I can be. But I want to hear the Lord say, well done. How many can say amen?
Amen.
I want to be count worthy to receive
yes.
rewards.
Yes.
Because I'll have something to cast down at the feet of Jesus. Amen. I don't want
amen.
No ashes.
Amen.
Amen. Casting down ashes, those works that were what? Didn't merit any rewards. Amen. All you would have a little old bag of ashes. Jesus, I didn't do nothing with my life much. Amen. I barely made it by the skin of my teeth. I repented on my deathbed. And Lord, all I have is just a bag of ashes. I'm just going to pull them down at your feet. Amen. The Lord don't want no ashes. majesty. Amen. He wants what? Those crowns. Crown of rejoicing. How many can say amen for the soul man? Woo, glory. Crown of rejoicing. Bible says the wise are going to shine. The wise are going to shine like the firmament. Daniel 12 and 3. Amen. 12 and... It says, and they that be wise, see the Bible says, he that when it sows is what? Wise. Amen. Those are the wise people. Those that are what? Concerned about souls. Because that's the mainest thing the Lord what left us here to do. Souls, amen. Souls, souls, souls. Alright. And they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament. And they that turn men into righteousness as the stars forever and ever. Daniel 12:3. Amen. Boy, I want to shine as the brightness. Amen. How many going to have a glow? Ooh, shine. Ooh, glory. If anybody got a flashlight you can put on me. Shine as the firmament. And they that turn men into righteousness as the stars forever. I'm going to be a star. I want to be a star. How many want to be a star? I believe it would be better to be a star than just what? Somebody walking around in heaven. Amen. Just walking around, well, what is she doing? I go over here and check on her. Bible says that they that overcome, they're going to be what? Placed over nations. How many would like to have a nation and get a whole nation saved? All right. Hey. Oh, this is some good stuff. Let me go back to Ezekiel because my time is out. Y'all going to tell Sister Hill on it? Hey, Michelle here? Y'all better. Woo! Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right, Ezekiel 3, it says this, Son of Man, 3:17, Son of Man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth, and give them warning from me. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way, to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Now, this is speaking about the man that you know that's in sin. And the Lord said, when I say that if you continue in sin, you're going to surely die, that wicked man, if you don't warn that wicked man to cause him to change from his wicked way, that man is the one going to die, just like a whole lot of people around you. A lot of people you know. And many times we just what? We're so soft and timid and weak-kneed and jelly-backed, we just want what? We won't confront. Amen. How many love me today? And we just what? We just what? Well, I don't want to rub nobody the wrong way. I don't want nobody what to turn against me. I don't want people to think wrong about me, think negative about me. And may you care less what they think. You trying to what? Save your soul. Amen. My brother used to preach, save yourself from this untoward generation. Save yourself. Is that right? Amen. God will require their blood. In other words, he will hold you accountable for their souls if you fail to warn them. All right. Well, y'all love me? Y'all still love me?
Yes.
That's category number one that we got to work. We got to be sure that we cover. You know, it doesn't mean that you just go out and try to find everybody and warn them. That means that, well, God is going to place certain people in your path. Then there are some people you can put yourself in that path.
Come on.
You're right? Amen. I wouldn't want to see nobody suffer the torments of hell as hell is described in the Bible. All right, the second category there. Oh, yes, yet if I warn the wicked and turn not from his wickedness nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul. You want your soul delivered. Touch somebody and say, you want your soul delivered. You don't want nobody's blood on you. Okay, when a righteous man doth turn from his righteousness, okay, watch this now. When a righteous man doth turn from his righteousness, this is a backslider. Everybody say a backslider. How many of we got backsliders in the church? backslide are the people that's going back. Sliding back.
All right.
A pretty simple definition there.
Yeah.
They're the people that's what? Sliding back.
Yeah.
Rather than moving forward, they are what?
Yeah.
Hey, the disciplines they used to embrace, they won't. They don't do that no more. Time that they what? Used to make time for the Lord, they don't do that.
All right.
We call them backsliders. They're sliding back. Amen. Amen. All right. When a righteous man doth turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die. Because thou hast not given him warning, he shall die in his sin. And his righteousness which he hath done shall not be remembered. But his blood will I require at thine hand. So look at that. See, he says that when a righteous man does turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, see, iniquity is nothing more than premeditated sin. Things that you think of and do, you premeditate it. Amen. You know you're going to do it before. It's not a slip up. It's something you plan. Is that plain enough? Something you plan. How many know? Amen. Praise God. That sometimes people plan out what they're going to do before they do it. That's iniquity. Amen. Don't shout me down. All right. Because I have not given him warning, he shall die in his sin and his righteousness. All of the good works he's done, he's not going to get credit for. They won't be remembered because he turned back. You're going to be wiped out. You won't get no credit at the judgment seat of Christ for that. As you die in your sin, the scripture says that, amen, that blood are going to be required at your hand. Amen. So there will be people that have done wonderful works for the Lord. They started out with a pure, sincere devotion. They started out really sincere, but they've been distracted by this, distracted by that. The Bible says the cares of life, deceitfulness of riches, the lust of other things. And there's so many things we could point to today that's what? Causing people to get distracted. And when it comes time to read the Bible, our mind ain't there. Our heart is not there. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. So you have to remember that a whole lot of people that's in the church that have done wonderful things, but they turned around and they haven't repented and got back and going back in the right direction, they're what? Still sliding what? Back. If you die in a backslidden condition, and the Bible says, without holiness, no man shall see the Lord, amen, praise God, then you know that you won't even get in by the skin of your teeth unless you repent on your deathbed. That might be possible. Unless you fall dead. Amen. That's the second category. Everybody said backsliders.
Backsliders.
All these backsliders in the church, and nobody know anybody that's backslide. Somebody ain't showed up, and how God knows how long, and what? They're backsliders. Everybody said backsliders. They're sliding back. You're sliding back. And you ain't gonna say nothing to him because you don't want to offend him. You're scared he ain't gonna like you. All right. Time is out, but I got one more category because next time this might not even be close to what I want to say. All right. The last category, nevertheless, if thou warn the righteous man, that the righteous man sin not, and he doth not sin, he shall surely live. Because he is warned, also thou hast delivered thy soul. That's the third category. These are, if thou warn the righteous man. See, the righteous man are people like most of y'all. All y'all look righteous to me here. Y'all look just as righteous as y'all can think. Well, man looks at y'all's appearance, but God looks at the what, huh? But y'all do look pretty good, pretty righteous. So I just give you the benefit of the doubt. Now my job and your job is to what? Warn the righteous. Why? Why does the righteous need to be warned?
Come on.
That's right. There you go, Brother Beard. I like you. They need to be what? Encouraged. They need to be what? Inspired. They need to be called. They need to be what? Admonished. They need to be what? Prayed with. Amen. Pray that they will stand what? Complete. In the will of God. All the will of God. Pray. Woo! That the eyes of their understanding might be enlightened. Pray that they might abound more and more and be sincere and without offense till the day of Jesus coming. Pray all these good prayers on them so they won't be able, they won't backslide. If not prayer power, it lays amen on them, they won't what? They won't turn and they won't start sliding back.
That's good. Amen. That's good.
And now I wish I could tell you about the crowns. My time is gone. And I'm scared y'all gonna tell it on me. Alright, I got one more thing I wanna say. Everybody, this is a warning. This is the third category. And second category. My warning is everybody that's missing Bible study, you're not in, you're not consistent, you can take it or leave it. You don't like it, you don't want it, you won't commit to it, you won't find time. Okay, here's my suggestion. Get the book, right, work the stuff out, and I can meet with you at 5 o'clock on Sunday evenings. I can call you on a one-on-one, or I can pray about something else. There's got to be a way that we can stop what? Backsliding. We got to begin to what? Move forward. I've never seen the day of Sister Elam. Amen. You pray for me, Sister Elam. Amen. Praise God. She's from the old school too. I've never seen the day that, amen, people, amen, are just different today. About 10 years ago, people were, you know, they would submit to things. But everybody now is just busy. Everybody's what? I ain't got time for no Bible, so I got to do this. I ain't got time for no prayer meeting. I got to what? I got to be here. Now, if we keep doing that and omitting and neglecting all of the things that God has designed to what? To cause you to be established in holiness, because he says, without holiness, what? No man shall what? See the Lord. What are we going to do to substitute for that? Unless the pastor takes time and figure out a way and try to weave you in and get you in on the mix so you can become a part of a what? Growth process, your chance is going to be what? Almost nil. I don't believe there's another church in this town that will be willing to make a commitment to help you like this, like I'm going to help you. Why did I put all those books together? Because I feel like at least if they're not hearing me in person, they could what? Read it at home. But I still got to what? Have some kind of accountability system. I got to what? See who's doing it, who's not, and I still got to what? I still got to sow in your life. If it comes to it, I'll call you on one-on-one. I don't believe too many of y'all want to deal with me on a one-on-one. But my heart goes out for you. And I know it's too late to be playing the kind of game we're playing now. It is just too late. It is just too late. It is just too late. Amen. People have been trying to figure out, but prophetic people have been trying to figure out. Amen. They are seeing that whether it will 2012 lead over to 2015 and be the 3 years that will bring in Armageddon. What's significant is all of this talk about the year 2012. I know China has already pledged 2015, we will overtake America. That's in their plans. That's in their plans. And guess who rolls back to power in Russia? Putin. He's the dictator that's supposed to be in charge during the Armageddon conflict. It's too close. It's too close, saints. close.
My.
And I want to do everything I can, amen, to keep you, amen, from shipwrecking and going over the cliff. Amen. It's going to take getting back. Everybody say, it's going to get back. Amen. Get back. Amen. Hallelujah. How many can say amen? I want everybody to stand with me today. Hey, hallelujah. Hallelujah.